We define a gene as an 8-character string where each character can be A, C, G, or T. We have an initial gene start, and we want to know the minimum number of mutations to perform to reach a gene end. A mutation is changing one character in a gene to one of the four possible letters of course. Knowing that, not all genes are valid. Valid genes that we can mutate to are given in a list bank. If it's not possible to reach end, return -1. For example, if start gene is AACCGGTT, end is AAACGGTA, bank of valid genes contains AACCGGTA, AACCGCTA, and AAACGGTA, then the output is 2, because we can reach end by performing 2 mutations only. By changing the last letter to A, we get a valid gene, then changing the third letter to A, we also get a valid gene, and it's the end gene. If there was no valid gene constraint, the problem would have been easy. We would just need to calculate the number of different characters between start and end genes, because we would use one mutation to fix each character. Basically, we would just need to calculate the Hamming distance between start and end genes. But with this constraint, we cannot perform any mutation we want. It must lead to a valid gene. How to solve this problem? Every time the problem consists of passing from a state to another one with different possible transformations, we can think of graph traversal algorithms. Because that's what we're doing here. We're traversing a graph. A graph where a vertex is a state, a gene, and an edge between two vertices means that we can move back and forth between them. And in this problem, it means that both genes are valid and that we can go from one to the other with a mutation. Mutation is what gives us the ability to move between states. And because here we want to reach end state with as less transformations as possible, we will use BFS, breadth first search. If you don't know BFS, watch this previous inside code video to understand how does it work and why we use it when we want to minimize the number of transformations. At the beginning, in our queue we have the start gene only. And from here we have 32 possible transformations. 32 because a gene has 8 characters, and each character can be replaced by one of the 4 letters A, C, G, T. And 8 times 4 gives 32. But not all mutations are valid. Remember that the new gene must be in the bank of valid genes. This is why among the 32 new genes, we enqueue only those that are in the bank and still unvisited. Then again, we dequeue, we try the 32 mutations, and enqueue unvisited genes that are in the bank. And so on until we either find the end gene or the queue becomes empty. All that while keeping track of how many mutations we needed to reach the actual state. Let's see an example. We have the start and end gene and this bank of valid genes. We dequeue the first node. Among the results of the 32 mutations, only 3 are unvisited and in the bank. We enqueue them. We dequeue ACCCGGTT. Among the results of the 32 mutations, only one of them is unvisited and in the bank. We enqueue it. Then we dequeue AAACGGTT. It discovers 2 new valid genes, one by changing the last T to C, and one by converting the last T to A. Then we dequeue AACCGGGT. It discovers no new valid genes. Then ACCCGGGT, no new genes. Then AAACGGTA, it discovers 1 new gene. Then AAACGGTC, 2 new genes. And here when we dequeue AAACCGTA, we find out that it's the end gene. And from start, we needed 3 mutations to reach it. We return 3. Let's try to code this solution. First things first, it's better to convert the bank of valid genes to a set, because checking existence in a set is faster than in a list. We can also add an early exit condition. If the end gene is not a valid gene, useless to search, we cannot reach it, we directly return -1. After it, we start writing our BFS algorithm as usual. we need a queue and a setVisited to store visited genes. For the queue, instead of storing the gene only, we also store its level, which represents how much mutations we did to reach it, because we need it when it's time to return the output. We need 0 mutations to reach start gene, so we store in the queue the tuple start 0. And in the visited set, we store the gene only, we don't need to store its level. We can start, we keep looping while the queue is not empty. At each iteration, we dequeue a tuple, which contains the gene and its level. Here we check if it's the end gene, if we found what we're searching for since the beginning. So if gene is equal to end, we return its level, the number of mutations. Else, we perform the 32 mutations and enqueue ones that are in the bank and unvisited. How to perform the 32 mutations? First of all, we have 8 characters, so we need a loop to traverse characters. Inside this loop, we traverse possible letters. For each letter in ACGT, we get the new gene by taking the part before the character I, we add to it the new letter, and we add the remaining part, the one after the character I. Now with the new gene, we check if it's not visited and if it's in the bank. If both conditions are respected, we can enqueue it. We enqueue the tuple new gene level plus 1. Level plus 1 because we used one more mutation to reach the new gene. And we add it to visited to not enqueue it again later. This process keeps getting repeated until either we find end gene or the queue becomes empty, which means we couldn't reach end gene. In that case, we return minus 1 as required by the problem. And we solved our problem by using breadth first search. If you have a question, you can ask in comments. You can also like and subscribe to support the channel or buy one of the courses in description. See you in the next one.